I'm in Bantry House in West Cork, one of hundreds of historic houses and estates that are owned and maintained by families across the country. Normally, 30,000 people would come here to visit the house and gardens, but at the moment, the only visitors are those that live within 5 kilometres. Earlier, I asked Julie Shelswell-White, whose family have lived here for centuries, how the fall in income is impacting on the maintenance of the estate.
It's always been a case of prioritising jobs here. I mean, we never got to do every single maintenance job that ever came up. We have 100 acres, so as you can imagine, it's an awful lot of work. Last year, we really had to prioritise and really just focus on keeping the place suitable to be open and safe for people to visit, and larger projects just had to be forgotten about, really.
Keeping the gardens and woodlands open to locals has been a priority. But Adam Carvath, the head gardener, doesn't have the manpower he used to.
Usually it would be me, and we'd have 2 students from France since March. We would have them for 12 weeks and there'd be another gardener. But last year and this year, it's a lot different. It's just me. And I'd be here 2 to 3 days a week. And maybe Sam, who's the son of the family here, would be helping as well every now and again. But he's usually here, down, everywhere.
And you've 100 acres to maintain. That's a big job.
It's 100 acres and it's a very historic garden. So it's very formal, but we have to somehow strike a balance because it's not, you know, we can't manage it to the way it used to be 200 years ago.
Some other historic houses have talked about trying to rewild areas of the land. Is that something that you've considered here, or do you just have to prioritise?
We do have to leave the odd weeding because I can't weed everything. And I think it's very pretty, and there's definitely a lot more interest from the public asking about wildflowers and what they can do in their garden too.
What would you say to them?
Definitely we need to do more for biodiversity and in terms of the climate, so I would leave areas wild. You don't have to be mowing your lawn every week. It's just a brutal job to be doing it every week. A lot of stress for a lot of people. So we say leave areas of the garden, let it grow, don't mow. So let the wildflowers come up and you enjoy the bees and the butterflies that come forward as well.
The move away from house to land is something many owners see as a positive to have emerged from the pandemic, as they strive to extend the legacy and heritage of these private estates and share it with the public. Sharon Tobin, RTE News, Bantry, County Cork.